question. What is money? What is money? Money is a non-existent theoretical force that has never, does not, and will never exist except in theory on computer screens. People die and starve because they don't have enough digits on a computer screen. It's incredible and it's extraordinary and it's grotesque, but unfortunately it's true. People think, what is money? Well, how is money created? There's another big question. Oh, it's governments. No! It's private banks lending non-existent money called credit. What is credit? There's your credit. That's it. When you go into a bank and you want to borrow $50,000, the bank doesn't print any money. It doesn't move precious metals anywhere. It types into your account $50,000, and from that moment, you start owing it not only $50,000, but the interest on the $50,000. And if you can't pay that back through no fault of your own, because the banking system has done what it's just done and you lose your job so you can't pay them back, they get your wealth that does exist, your home, your car, your business, your land. It's been going on for centuries. This is why it has sucked the wealth of the world into the hands of the few. What is an economic boom? It's when there's lots of units of exchange, money, in circulation, creating lots of economic activity, which causes people to have confidence in the economic situation. In those times, they get more and more in debt because they're so confident. Or we can have a bigger house, a bigger car, two vacations, and all the rest of it. And the banking system, controlled by the same people and coordinated by the same people, have put that out there, fishing line out. Lots of credit. Hey, what do you mean you earn, $2 an hour? You want a $500,000 mortgage? No problem. Here you go. Gotcha out there. It doesn't matter. We're getting the house eventually anyway. And then what they do is they take money out of circulation. They're pulling the bloody line in now. And as they take money out of circulation, oh no, we've got a credit crunch, we can't make loans and give you any more money that doesn't exist and charge you interest on it. Oh no, it's real serious. We haven't got a problem though, because they'll bail us out, because we control them, you see. So, and then what happens if we move over here into a slump or a depression? Not because anyone doesn't want to work, not because people want to lose their homes, but because there is not enough units of exchange in circulation for the economic activity to go on that allows them to earn the money to pay back the loans. So now the banks go, thank you very much, I'll have some of that. And the only difference between a boom and a bust is what the private banking cartel has allowed as units of exchange through credit or not through credit. I heard a politician. They all look the same to me. I don't know, I can't tell them apart. They've all got dark suits with heads on and their mouths are moving. That's all I can... Oh, I've seen someone in the last few days. Someone yesterday, some politician or other, said that they had to bail out the banks here with more debt for the people who've already been screwed by those they're supposed to get out of trouble. Main Street cannot function without credit. People can't pay their bills without credit. Big question. What the hell system allows that to be the case?
Perhaps we need some outside universal threat. I occasionally think how quickly our differences worldwide would vanish if we were facing an alien threat from outside this world. And yet, I ask you, is not an alien force already among us?